Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome back to another English video. In today's video, I want to talk to you all about four little words. Little, a little, few, and a few. And we're going to start straight away by talking about what they are. And we're going to continue showing you some example sentences, when we use them, what kinds of word we use them with. And also, you'll have Colin's notes at the end to try and get more information on how to use these four words. Let's start by looking at little and few without the article a. Now, they mean the same, but they're used slightly differently. As you can see from the video clip here, I have moved some boxes. Why? Because there was little space. Now, space is uncountable. It's an uncountable noun. It cannot be counted. So I use little instead of a little. We'll get to that later. There was little space, and now there's more. When I say little, it gives off a kind of negative feeling. If we go over to my fridge here, we can see few tins of beans. Not a few, we can see few without the article a. Why? There are less than I hoped or wished. And that's why we use little and few. Little with uncountable nouns, few with countable nouns. Okay? So there was little space, less than I wanted, less than I imagined, less than I hoped for. Not enough. And few tins of beans. Not enough. I love beans, okay? Who doesn't love English Heinz baked beans? There wasn't enough in the fridge. There was less than I imagined. So that's when we use few tins. Tins, tin, of course, is countable. So we have to use few here and not little. Next up, we're going to look at a little and a few. Again, they have the same meaning, but that meaning is different to the first meaning of just little and few. Okay, a little is used with uncountable nouns. A few is used with countable nouns, and they mean something a little bit different. If we go back to the video of me removing those boxes from the shelves, removing those books from the shelves, before there was little space. After I moved them, there was a little space. Can you see the difference? So little space, negative. A little space, it's more positive, yeah? It's not a lot, but that's what it means. A little is closer to the meaning of some. And so is a few. Now, if you look at this guy here, we can see he's rather happy. Why? He has one of his favorite things. He has a few bars of chocolate. Bars, countable. We must use a few and not a little. A few bars of chocolate makes this guy really, 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 really happy. So a little, uncountable nouns to mean something close to some. A few also means something close to some. A few chocolate bars this guy had. Now that that's out of the way, we're going to compare little and a little to try and go a little bit deeper and to show you the actual difference between the two. Now imagine you have a party which starts at 7 o'clock, right? And it takes 20 minutes to get to this party. So you want to give yourself enough time, okay? Imagine you're getting ready for the party and it's now 6:30. The party's 20 minutes away. You have little time to get there. Not a little time. Little time. It's a negative connotation that it suggests that you've not got a lot of time. Now, conversely, if it's 6:10, so 10 past 6, you have a little time to get there. You have more, close to some. You have some time to get there, yeah? You can take a little bit longer getting ready, okay? So, little time to get there, it's negative. It's too tight. A little time gives you more breathing space, okay? The same goes for few and a few. We've already discussed the rules behind them. Let's take a kid, for example, or let's take an adult who once was a kid. What? That doesn't sound right. An adult who once was a kid. Deep. Many adults have memories from when they were kids. Few memories and a few memories are totally different. If I say I have few memories of my time as a kid, I have few memories from my childhood. It's really negative. It suggests that my childhood wasn't that good. Whereas if I say, I have a few childhood memories, or I have a few memories from my childhood, it suggests that I had a nice childhood. It's more positive. Okay, so that's the difference between either using the article a or not using it. When we use it, it's more positive. Without, less positive. Now, straight into Colin's notes, some different ways I want to show you on how we can use these words, especially little. Now, we have something in English called determiners. Determiners are basically words like my, your, his, her. These are possessive adjectives, but they come under the group of determiners. A and the are also determiners. There's many other types of words. Some, any, they're all determiners, right? If we want to use some of those determiners, we need to use little, a little, few, and a few of. plus these determiners, right? Some examples. Little of my time is spent doing useful things. Negative connotation. It means I don't do many useful things, right? A few of my friends are going out tonight. Because I use my before friends, we need to use a few of. A few my friends? No. A few of my friends. Little of my time. Time uncountable. Little of my time. Okay? A little can also be used as an adverb. Now, adverbs are just words like very, really, beautifully, dangerously, okay? They modify verbs and other adverbs. When we use a little, we want it to mean something like a bit, but it's a bit more formal. So, one example, when I have a lot of chocolate or pizza, I smile a little. When I have a test the next morning, I worry a little. You see? So, little modified worry and smile. Instead of just saying I worry or I smile, it's very basic. We can add words like a little, a bit, just to give them some flavor, some color, okay? Now it can also be used to modify adjectives. For example, comparative adjectives even in this case. I'm a little happier than I was yesterday. Yesterday I was a little ill. Today I'm a little happier because I'm not so ill. I'm not as ill as I was yesterday, so I'm a little happier. Don't eat for a long time, you're a little hungrier, right? You see, little can modify adjectives also. And finally, little can just be an adjective, like big, small, hungry, skinny, lovely, okay? And it does mean something similar to small, but again, it's about positive and negative connotations, right? Imagine, compare these sentences. If I said to you, let's go to a restaurant down in the city, let's go to a restaurant in the city center tomorrow. It's a small restaurant in the city. Small just refers to size. It's small. It suggests to me that it's small and it's probably not a good idea, but imagine I said to you, let's go to a nice little restaurant in the city center tomorrow. It's positive, yeah? It's really positive. Let's go to a nice little restaurant in the city. Oh, look at that little baby. The baby is small, by the way, but look at that little baby. It suggests positive emotion, okay? And that is all your uses of little and, further back in the video, a few. And few. And little. And a little. Thanks very much for sticking around till the end of the video, guys. If you did, check my other videos which appear on screen. Subscribe, like, share, and leave comments. What did you enjoy about today's video? What did you not enjoy? What would you like to see more of? What were the hardest parts of today's video? What were the easy parts? What did you know? What did you not know? Let me know in the comments below and I will get back to you, certainly if you leave one. Thank you very much and see you in the next video, guys. Cheers.